Go get him.
He's alive.
Go get him. There we go. So we got Periscope. Hold on, Periscope. Y'all be talking ish on Periscope. I like that. What up? Hi. What's happening? I'm going to change the music. I'll be right back. Can't hear? What's up, Gwen? What's up, Jacket? Periscope, can you hear me? What's up, Royal? What's up? I should be out partying. Should be. Look, we've been doing Mardi Gras since All-Star Week, all right? There y'all go. Keep coming. Happy Mardi Gras. What's up? That's right. Look, go share this on Periscope. Go share this on Facebook. Let's get ready to do this. I'm gonna be honest with everybody. Look, I just got back in from Orleans and Claiborne, all right? It's been a long day, but I'm hungry, and we're about to have some fun, all right? Changing up the music. I know we normally do trap kitchen. We normally have some great trap music, but we're gonna make this thing New Orleans style, all right, y'all? We're gonna play a little bit of that brass band music in a few minutes. Mike Hunt. What's happening, Mike Hunt, on my Periscope? I don't know who Mike Hunt is, but what's happening, Mike Hunt? Who's Mike Hunt on Periscope? Can y'all hear that clip? Facebook Live, can you hear that? Periscope, can you hear that? What's up, Mike? Can y'all hear that? Facebook Live? Periscope, can we hear that? Cut it up, we're gonna cut this thing up. All right, y'all hear that? You just got jacked off Periscope, smart ass. Periscope, watch all those stragglers, all those little goons that think they're gonna interrupt this. Y'all get in that mood? Look, some of y'all didn't believe in superstition. I'll open up a whole umbrella and just get it. Let's go. All right, y'all. Let's get this thing started. Facebook Live, we clear? Periscope, we clear? Give me some hearts. Give me some thumbs up on Facebook. Give me some hearts on Periscope and we clear. Yeah. We good. All right. For those of you who do not know me, my name is Kenneth Temple. I am a private chef in New Orleans, Louisiana. I cook for NFL, NBA, politicians, Grammy artists, celebrity chefs. I see you on there, Chef Jeff. How you feeling, King? I travel the world all the way to Durban, South Africa, each and every year to bring global cuisine of New Orleans, Louisiana, to the world. And welcome to the Trap Kitchen Mardi Gras edition. Y'all can see it was nice and hot in New Orleans today. I'm letting my trainer see I've been working out. Letting my trainer see I've been working out. Been working out. So look, I got a special guest here. She claimed she was coming to New Orleans. So we're gonna do the damn thing. Look, share this. Periscope, share it. Twitter, Facebook. Facebook, share this live stream. We're about to have some fun. But before I bring my special guest on, y'all wanna know what we're cooking tonight? Periscope, give me some hush, y'all ready to know. Facebook Live, give me some love if y'all wanna know. We are cooking something that is so traditional, but I'm about to put my little twist on it. Y'all ready? Periscope ready? Facebook Live, y'all ready? All right. Tonight, I am making a fried chicken buttermilk biscuit sandwich with a red bean sauce. That's right. Fried chicken with a buttermilk biscuit and a red bean sauce. What y'all think about that? All right, y'all ready? So look, while we're about to cook this great food, I hope y'all both respect how we work in this angle in the Trap Kitchen. So Periscope, when you see me look this way, I'm looking at Facebook Live, when you see me look this way, I'm looking at Periscope. So, I met this young lady on the Black Food Network. She was talking all that she was coming to New Orleans for Mardi Gras. I've been showing around, I'm not hoarse. Miko and the dish, ladies and gentlemen. Come on, Miko. Look at you, man. Where you get them beans from, bro?
Hey, I've been Mardi Gras-ing. I ain't got no umbrellas, so I'm gonna use this whisk. What? Hey, what's up, Facebook Live? What's up, Periscope? How y'all? I trumped them. Check me out. Check me and my beads out. I'm super festive. Check out my hair, my gold star, my green wig. Since Nicki Minaj got bodied, I thought I'd take her wig in.
Oh.
You know what I'm saying?
Nicki Minaj.
Damn. Since Nicki got bodied, I thought I'd borrow her wig so she don't need it no more. Hey! Give me some hearts, folks.
What do we think? We think Donald Trump is the president of the United States. Thank you very much. That's our thoughts on Donald Trump. All right, so I don't know who she know, but did you do what they do on Bourbon? Did you show
her? There was no lifting up of the blouse. Yeah. It was my beautiful smile that attracted the people on the floats. Right?
I'm gonna show a nipple next year. Hopefully I get a bigger beat. Alright, y'all. So Miko's here. Miko, you making a drink, right?
Yeah, you know, so I heard in the South you have to show hospitality, and you've been hosting me for the last couple days, so I thought I'd come there and get. I'm bringing a Mardi Gras daiquiri. A Mardi Gras daiquiri.
Is it strong or is it weak? I mean, you know, we're gonna find
out.
Don't
doubt me now.
Alright.
Don't doubt me. Okay.
So, put that battery on the charger. All right, y'all. Let's get in this kitchen. Facebook Live.
Hey, what's up, Toya and Y?
Lord, on Facebook. Lord.
There we go. Okay, so what did you say you was making again?
We are doing a fried chicken with a buttermilk biscuit with a red bean sauce.
I've never heard of a red bean sauce.
Now, look, traditionally in New Orleans, you get your red beans, you get your fried chicken, you get some type of combine the two together, and we're gonna have some fun.
That sounds pretty genius.
All right, turn it up in Street Report. Facebook Live, y'all ready to get in this thing? Can y'all see that? We're Facebook Live. Yep, Facebook Live got that. All right. So, in this bowl, what we have here is flour, baking powder, some salt, some baking soda, and a little extra tip, since we're making this a little savory, we're gonna put some black pepper in that biscuit. Have you ever had black pepper in your biscuits before?
I don't recall putting that much black pepper in my biscuits. Maybe white pepper, not black.
Well, you in the South, babe. I'm about to show you a couple of ones and twos. So we're just going to stir that on up. Your hands washed, Nico?
My hands are clean, honey, but all I'm right. Watching one more time for the folks on the scope and on the Facebook Live.
I'm going to put Nico to work. She in the trap kitchen. She ain't getting no free meal for nothing. So we're going to throw some butter in there. Butter acting bad. What you know about brass music, Nico?
Not a whole lot, but I know I like it. When I hear it, I just want to, like, you know, kind of shake my hips a little bit.
That's how you got them beads. That's how you got them beads.
Ah, Jesus.
All right, y'all, look. They got cute little instruments you can use to make your biscuits crumble, but no better instrument than these tools that you got, all right? So you just want to get that nice and crumble. Can y'all see that? Miko, they want to know if you're enjoying yourself.
I am having the time of my life. I've never done Mardi Gras, so this has been an awesome experience. I think anybody who is interested should at least do it once in their life. It was so much fun. I had a blast.
So where did you go for Mardi Gras?
I went to a couple things. So I went to the Zulu Ball, where I got to get fancy and dress up, you know, show them a little something, show the South what I'm working with. And I've gone to a couple parades. And today's parade was the Zulu parade, actually, the folks who put on the Zulu Ball, put on this parade. And so, it was awesome. It was like all these great bands performing, you know, the girls in the bands were wearing like these shimmery outfits and, you know, walking all down the parade route. Lots of big cloaks. So much fun.
Y'all see that? Y'all see that crumbling texture? That's what y'all want. That's what y'all want. What up, Darius? We doing a little fried chicken, buttermilk biscuit sauce. Yeah, it's loud, Darius. It's supposed to be loud. It's Mardi Gras. Buttermilk biscuits with a little bit of red bean sauce. We're going to add that buttermilk to that there. And we're just going to stir it with a little fork. Now you want to make sure you're paying attention. Anytime you're making a dough, you want to watch it just pull apart from the bowl. And once it pulls apart from the bowl, you know that all the flour, all the gluten that you want is well incorporated. All right? So it's going to take a few minutes. Nico, since you're playing DJ, throw me a spatula. That'll work. So look, I like a wet biscuit. I don't like my biscuit to be too dry. There we go. Y'all see that dough? That's what we want. Miko, come back. Where you went? You're supposed to be working.
I'm DJing.
All right. I'm going to get you to go ahead on. You know how to roll out dough?
Yeah, I can roll out dough. Put a little flour on there for me.
All right. Now look, since we're going to make a sandwich out of this, we don't want no little small punk biscuits, all right? So knead it about 5 times.
Okay.
And then we'll be done. Knock it off your custard bag. Hey!
You don't like the way I fold dough?
Don't need dough like Nico or Periscope.
Show me how you need the dough.
You didn't need it enough. I don't need to need it no more. There y'all go, right there. Nice little ball of dough. Y'all see that? Now look, if y'all don't have a fancy roller like I have, use a wine glass. And if y'all have a wine glass, go buy your fancy roller. All right, hold on, Miko. Your hands clean? Yeah. I want you to lift this up so Periscope can catch this roll action. All right, look. When you're doing a biscuit, you want to be very, very gentle, all right? You don't want to get your workout in. You don't want to roll on out of there. I like to do up and back and then diagonal. And a little bit to the side. So look. All right? Because this is the size biscuits so we can have a sandwich, all right? Miko, I hope you got your appetite.
I'm hungry. I'm starving. I've been in the sun all day.
We might literally get 4 biscuits out of this. All right. Put that on the baking sheet.
You don't need to do nothing to the baking sheet?
No, see that? See the size of that biscuit? See all those little layers on there?
That's what my folding did. My kneading.
Yeah, that's exactly what it did. Exactly what it did. All right. And then just take this dough. Knead it one quick little time, not too much. Make another little ball. And at this point, I just flatten it out with my hands, y'all. There we go. Get one good biscuit right out the middle.
Beautiful, now, look at those.
Now look, you want flaky, fluffy biscuits, don't knead it to oblivion, all right? That always helps with the flake and with the rising of the dough. The more you knead it, the more the gluten form, the less it pops up and gives you that nice flake. Like, see this one here? It's gonna be all extra crumbly. But I'm gonna flip him over and stick him to the side. All right, so I'm gonna pop these in the oven for about 12 to 15 minutes, and then we're gonna have some fun. I'm gonna break this all down, clear this all up, and then we're gonna get to frying some chicken. Little loofah. You know about the loofah. I don't need it. I don't want to do that. Don't be that guest. So hold on. While you're in here, I want you to talk to the people about what you got in this Mardi Gras cocktail.
Oh, okay. Yeah. Let me show you guys a little bit what I'm working with, what I've been inspired by since I've been here. Actually, let me bring this up so you guys can hang out with me for a little bit. So for the Mardi Gras cocktail, and this is what I've noticed since I've been, this is what I learned. Like, you guys like to do a lot of things in threes.
Trios, yeah.
Trios, the Trinity, right? All those yummy flavors in the Trinity. You guys start everything with the Trinity, and then your Mardi Gras colors are like green, purple, and gold or yellow, and I've seen that all throughout the day. Clearly, I'm wearing it, and so my cocktail, you'll see layers of those three colors, or my daiquiri, and in it, I'm using Tito's vodka and some really simple other ingredients to pull those flavors off. So I got some of those. Let me see if I have the can. Did you throw my can away? Here we go. You guys know these things that you get in the grocery store, the little flavored beverages. So I got all the ones that are like, you know, match these colors. I got the margarita flavor, I got a peach daiquiri flavor, and I got like a Welch's grape flavor. And then to bring out the colors more, I got Kool-Aid to match. Super simple, blend it up. I know y'all drink some Kool-Aid. So I got Kool-Aid to bring out those flavors, blend it up real nice with the Tito's, and layer it up. So that's what we're making tonight from me. I'm gonna have the best stuff on the menu, if I do say so myself.
Oh, have mercy. How many times do you drink Kool-Aid, Miko?
How many times have I drunk Kool-Aid in life?
How many times a year do you drink Kool-Aid?
I would say less than one time a year.
So you choose Mardi Gras for that to be your Kool-Aid night?
Kool-Aid is a great way to add in color without adding in liquid, more liquid. We want it to be like a slushy, like a daiquiri, so Kool-Aid brings out that color that we need. Come on now. Why is he hating on me on the use of Kool-Aid? How do you drink Kool-Aid in a year?
I don't drink Kool-Aid no more.
Well, no judgment, okay? This should be a judgment-free zone. Let's see what's going on. What are you guys commenting? Come in, blah, 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 blah. Don't hate on the... Thank you! Don't hate on the Kool-Aid! Don't hate on the Kool-Aid.
I'm just trying to see how many times you can really drink this stuff. Or you just was inspired by the laid-back culture in New Orleans.
First of all, nothing in New Orleans said I needed to drink Kool-Aid. It was only because I know that Kool-Aid brings out color. People dye their hair with Kool-Aid. No lie. People dye their hair with Kool-Aid.
Excuse me.
Switching places. Okay, what you doing next?
Darius agrees with the Kool-Aid.
Boom!
Okay.
Boom. Thank you, D. Thank you, D. Black Food Network. Thank you, D.
If y'all go to blackfoodnetwork.com, y'all can find a great Kool-Aid slushy. It's an adult Kool-Aid.
Yeah, an adult Kool-Aid.
So I know why he's gonna like that Kool-Aid. So look. All right. This chicken should normally go for about 8 hours overnight, right? But I've been at Mardi Gras since like 8 o'clock this morning.
Keep it real.
And right now what we're going to do is call a quick buttermilk dip. You know what I'm talking about? Say it with me, y'all. Quick buttermilk dip. All right. So we're going to take some of this buttermilk. And we're just going to fill it up. So yeah, that's right. We got buttermilk biscuits. And we got buttermilk in our chicken. Now, I first came up with this recipe during a rehearsal dinner for my client. Oh, this is a little bit of that. My secret to anything I brine, I use more seasoning and herbs than salt because I like to over-season my brine so it has a deeper concentration of flavor rather than highly in salt, you know.
Okay.
So, it's really a personal preference. How seasoned do you like it? We definitely gonna season up the flour, but we won't need to season the chicken because this brine technique over the time period that it will literally marinate will have put so much depth of flavor into it. All right? Now look, we're in the NOLA and we frying chicken. I gotta add a little bit of that cayenne to that thing. I hope you don't mind a little spice, Nico.
I love spice. Okay.
All right, so we're gonna add a little bit of that cayenne to that there. See this color? Y'all see that color right there? Facebook Live, you see that color? Periscope, you see that color? Miko, do you see that color?
I see it.
That's what you want. All right,
what's your question? Break? I have a question. Oh, actually, I have a statement. So y'all on Periscope, you see your little uncle with the bald head over in the right bottom corner? Why don't you push your uncle to tell them that you love them, right? And then share this with your friends. You too on Facebook, share this with your friends. Bring people into this scope, this live, so they can see what's happening down in the NOLA. Some of this good Southern food.
Yes, tap your uncle.
Tap your bald-headed uncle.
The bald-headed pimp.
Yep.
I think I seen the pimp dressed for walking around with a red suit, just Mardi Gras.
Yes, I definitely saw that guy.
All right, so I got some boneless, skinless thighs right here. Now look, if y'all like white meat, y'all can go ahead on and do your white meat. I like me a little dark meat that has more flavor, it's more tender, it's juicy.
So me, you like
white
dark
or dark meat?
I like dark meat.
I like dark meat.
Yeah.
Bang your ass. Alright. So since we're doing a quick brine, I'm just gonna season it up with a little bit of salt.
Okay.
Just a little bit of salt, a little bit more.
Look at that sprinkle technique.
I mean, you know. Always season your food high, ladies and gentlemen. You don't want botching the seasoning. We're gonna hit it with a little salt and pepper. Season both sides. Nobody like when you bite in one piece of meat, it tastes like heaven, and the next side it tastes like purgatory.
Happy Tuesday. Thank you for sharing, Velvet 54.
There you go, Facebook Live. I want y'all to catch y'all that. So look, if y'all want this recipe and any other recipe from Trap Kitchen, make sure you go to chefkennethtemple.com, sign up on the email list, and I will be having this out to y'all in a couple of days. Now look, I know some of y'all was looking for that Trap Kitchen recipe from last week. The company whose recipe I used quit on everybody who used them, but y'all should have got an email today with all of those recipes for y'all. Let me know if you didn't get it, but definitely go to chefkennethtemple.com and sign up so we can have so much fun.
That looks well seasoned. You want to show the folks what, how good that? Yeah.
Well, she said it's well seasoned. You know, y'all know she a San Diego girl. She knows.
Whoa! What are you trying to say?
That you know good food.
Oh, okay. All right. We can roll with that. Don't get her just getting in front of your followers.
So look, we're just gonna take this and drop it in a quick brine buttermilk, all right?
Okay.
Ugh. So what you wanna do? Hold this with Paris.
Yeah. What am
Nico's
I doing?
Gonna be a camera. Come on.
I'm a camera person. Okay. Get inside this bowl.
So look, this is what y'all want, all right? Let this make love like a Keith Sweat song or Johnny Gill. Don't let it make love like Trey Songz or Chris Brown. They always getting in trouble with women. You want to make love like some men who always have satisfied women. You see that right there? Y'all see this? Let this sit for about 6 hours, 8 hours, 12 hours.
Yeah.
This chicken gonna be so tender. The buttermilk and the acid and all the natural little nutrients that's in this is gonna break this down and make it so tender. I'm almost tempted to leave this and forget y'all for the rest of the night and fry this thing up.
I'm hungry, so that's not gonna work.
Thank you, Miko, for being the voice of the people. Alright? So, what we're gonna do is we're gonna let this sit, we're gonna let this make a little love. I'm gonna cut this fire off, and then we're gonna make this red bean sauce. Y'all ready for that red bean sauce? Give me a two. Throw me some tools if y'all ready for this red bean sauce. Ooh, we got some dishes today.
Here's my twos, I'm ready.
Miko's ready. Y'all ready? Nick is ready. Shut that fire up. Can y'all see that Facebook Live? This skillet?
You don't need to bring y'all can what's going on.
Come on with it. All right.
Go here with the rest of the folks. All right.
Now, what we're about to do is use a technique called rendering. Now, Facebook Live, Periscope, I want y'all to look at Periscope since we got a heart. So, rendering is when you take something and you let it cook out all its natural fats and let it just release all this juiciness, all that crispy bits, right? So, I'm going a little bit healthier with the turkey sausage, but please feel free to use any sausage you want. All right? So, since turkey doesn't have a lot of bit of love into it.
What do you mean by a lot of bit of love?
It doesn't have a high fat content.
Ah.
So, since it doesn't have a high fat content, you need to add a little bit of fat. So, we just add a little bit of oil to that. Now, we just got the skillet nice and hot. And we're just gonna let it do its thing. Now, a killer technique is to start this in a cold pan. So as the temperature begins to rise, it's already cooking every step of the way. All right? And that's what you want. I'm gonna let this get nice and brown. I'm committing a New Orleans sin because I don't have one red beans, all right? The whole point of this is to get it done and get it over with. All right? Y'all with me? What's in the can? So look, this is Kitchen 101, all right? They be selling y'all that fancy equipment, fancy cute little things to hold your utensils. Look, take an old can, rinse it out, peel off the paper, and stick some water in there. And I keep my little utensils up in here. You know, I keep all my utensils to keep them clean.
That's a good little tip. I like that.
All right, so look, don't be spending $30 in Walmart and Kmart trying to get Facebook Live, stop hating. Facebook, I say, give me your $30. All right. Look here, William Lee. Next time I make this red bean sauce, I'm going to get you. So look, I know some of y'all may be lost with the canned red beans. But look, the whole point of this red bean sauce is not supposed to be the same Creole style red beans that takes 2 to 3 hours to make. The whole point of this sauce is to be a sauce. It's something that you can make quick at home, c- come back from a long day at Mardi Gras like I just finished doing and make a beautiful meal. All right? Now, I know all y'all can dig that because I know all y'all work. I know all y'all work. What you think about the canned red beans, Nico?
I mean, it's a great shortcut when you don't have the time. I'm not hating.
So look, also, everybody can't get camellia red beans all across the nation, all right? But we can definitely get these red beans anywhere canned. But don't get these aren't them runner beans. Those other guys who make those runner beans. I like these because they're nice and they're a whole bean. It's already cooked. All the work is done. They already boiled it for me. So it's gonna cook nice and quick.
Get a nice color to that sausage.
Hold on, y'all.
Oh, shoot.
Hold on, y'all.
Oh, man. Those are
Facebook
beautiful.
Live.
And the thing, I needed that.
Facebook
you,
Live.
You see my word?
Buttermilk biscuits. Nico, I'm not acknowledging anything you did. You see the size of them biscuits?
Beautiful.
This is the biscuits Martin Payne was talking about, not my mama biscuits. You know what I'm saying? So look, I'm gonna melt a little bit of butter, glaze it right over the top. But this right here, y'all see that fluff right there? Y'all see that line? Y'all see that line right there? Well, let me put the foil on. Y'all see that line right there? Woo! Going right there. Buns up. You're right, Josh. Buns up.
It smells so good.
We're gonna sit that to the side. All right. Woo! So look, crispy. Mm-hmm. Nice and crispy. But then also the secret to this dish, can y'all see that brown on the bottom of the pot?
Yeah.
That brown right there, that's your flavor. Do not rinse this pot out. And I'm gonna beat you alive. I'm gonna leave you alive so you don't make that mistake again, all right? So, that's what you want. That's a good render. Now, what I'm going to do is, because I want some of that texture at the back end of my red beans. Welcome to the Trap Kitchen if you're just joining. Mardi Gras edition. My name is Kenneth Temple. I am a private chef in New Orleans, Louisiana. I cook for NFL, NBA players, politicians, Grammy, Hollywood producers. I travel the world cooking Creole Cajun food. I work with Fortune 500 companies. If y'all want these recipes, go to Chef Kenneth. Live, stop hating, make sure you share this. And we're gonna have some fun. If you want this recipe, make sure y'all get this.
Ooh, what's next?
Now look, Miko talking about we love things in threes. You got your bell pepper, you got your onion, you got your celery. This is our holy trinity. We just gonna drop that in there. All right? We gonna drop that in there. And just let all of it. Miko, you smell them flavors right quick?
Yeah, I can smell them. It smells amazing in here.
So look, this is a quick red bean, all right? We're not making Creole red beans for 1 hour to feed the family. We're making a quick little sauce. And the whole point of why we're using so much seasoning, this is seasoning in New Orleans, all right? Your vegetables, we call this seasoning. Not just your herbs and spices, we call this seasoning, all right? The reason why we're using so much is because we want a beautiful, deep, concentrated flavor in that red bean sauce. But then I'm gonna take some of this after it cooks down and I'm gonna put this in the back end after we puree the red bean sauce to make it nice and lovely. All right, so everything always needs to be seasoned. First left, a little salt. We're gonna hit it with a little bit of salt. I always like to add salt in my first layers so it can draw out all that moisture and let the caramelization begin to build and develop flavors. You know about caramelization, Miko?
I know a thing or two about caramelization.
What you know about caramelization?
Well, like you said, the sugars, natural sugars are breaking down. The heat's bringing out, drawing out the natural sugars. It starts to brown everything down the bottom. Sometimes it gets sticky at the bottom as a result. Mm-hmm. That's all that good stuff that you want.
Yes, yes. Now look, y'all remember all that brown that was on the bottom of the skillet?
It's gone.
the vegetables have sucked it up. That's why you don't want to get rid of it. So all that flavor from the sausage is now in the vegetables. That's flavor heaven right there, y'all. This is going to create a food memory for somebody. This is going to create a mouthgasm. I can promise that. Hit it with a little bit of that savory. Yeah. All right, while that's working, I'm going to break down a little bit of garlic.
To bring
the folks
back over?
Keep them right over there watching
that skillet. Alright. You must think I'm Superman holding this up this whole time, y'all. Periscope, I'm literally holding you guys.
Hold the world.
Holding the world
right
now. Can I get some hearts for this amazing hold that I'm doing right now, Periscope? Look at that. Look at all these angles I'm giving you. Life.
Hold the world, Nico.
Hashtag life. Thank you, Scope!
Make sure y'all share this on Facebook. Make sure y'all share this on Periscope.
My pleasure, folks. My pleasure.
So we got some nice flavors. We got some beautiful color.
Mm-hmm.
We got some lovely color. So what I'm going to do with this is, I'm going to save a little bit of this, Miko.
Uh-huh.
And I'm going to put this on top of the fried chicken.
Oh, a little garnish.
A little garnish.
Okay, I like it. Life, hashtag lifesaver. Yup, that's me. Call me lifesaver.
So I'm going to throw some of that sausage back in.
Okay. Oh, okay. I see what you're doing.
I'm going to throw some of the sausage. I'm going to throw the garlic in there.
I love garlic.
Good. I got about 2 teaspoons of garlic in there. I'm going to throw the red beans in there.
Why do you put the garlic in last?
Because garlic cooks very, very fast. I like to, anytime I give a recipe, I always say cook until garlic is fragrant, and that's literally about 10 seconds.
Okay.
Anything past that, the garlic will begin to burn, and you'll have to start from scratch. And we don't want to start from scratch. This is working beautiful. This is working beautiful. We're going to throw a little bay leaf in there. Shout out to Bay. We're going to crumble up some fresh thyme. Put some fresh thyme. Now look, thyme is not like parsley or cilantro. Thyme and oregano, they are very woodsy, so they can hold up to long cooking. So you always want to add those earlier. Put your parsley, your green onion, cilantro, basil, always add that at the end so you can get the natural flavors. But
That's a great tip, Chef. Oregano.
Oregano.
Why you say it like that?
Because I like having fun in the trap kitchen. So we're going to put a little bit of oregano in there. And you'll begin to just get a whiff.
I can see that oregano. Was fast.
You
that
get a whiff of the oregano
so
soon as it hits, right?
Amazing. Guys, I wish you could smell this.
Shh. This is the secret stuff in my red beans. A little bit of cumin.
Jacking that.
A little bit of cumin. It gives it. The cumin brings out a nice smoky flavor that the turkey sausage doesn't give that we're so used to in our red beans. And I just love that extra kick of smoke in there. So I'm just gonna go ahead on and stir this up. Stir this up. And then I'm gonna bring it to a boil. Yeah. Give it a little chicken stock. But also with the chicken stock, I'm adding a little Worcestershire sauce.
Ooh, like my favorite ingredient of all time.
You know a little thing too. I'm cooking great food, huh? All right, so we're gonna let that come to a boil. Y'all see that? Facebook Live. This is about to come to a boil, and we're gonna let it work, all right? Now, we're gonna come back, we're gonna taste it before we puree it, and then we'll know where we want our flavors. I want a beautiful New Orleans style dish in this thing here. I'm gonna remove the bay leaf and I'm gonna hit it with this fancy tool right here. This is a stick blender. Since Miko's using all of my
blenders.
Stick blender. Look, this thing costs about $20 to $30, all right?
Worth
this is
it.
Quick for smoothies.
Totally,
you can get this at Walmart, Kmart, Bed Bath & Beyond. Oh, for all y'all big money grips who love calling me to come cook your dinner party. You go to Williams-Sonoma and get a beautiful one like this. But look, these kitchen tools do not have to break the bank. There's always a sale somewhere, so just be on the lookout. Stick blenders, they work good for quick sauces. Like, they work good for any quick smoothies that you want to do. That's what I'm talking about. So look. Can y'all see that? Miko's blocking it, but.
What am I blocking?
The light.
I can't do nothing right in this trap kitchen. Lord.
I think it's so perfect.
There's so many rules in the trap kitchen.
Yeah, man, that's how you don't do
that. There's so many rules in this trap kitchen. Yes, I am so excited. This is what I'm super excited about.
Good eating.
Yes, good, honey.
Good eating.
So good. Oh Lord.
So look, that's balling.
They said, Kenneth, leave her alone. Thank you, whoever said that.
That's balling. Now I'm going to throw it on the back end. And we're going to go ahead on and get ready to make this chick.
Okay.
All right, y'all, walk with me, talk with me. Y'all. Come back over here.
Give me my back a break. Thank
you. All right. Is that a stock? Yes, yes, nigga. That's a stock. That's a little chicken stock. All right. Woo. Miko bought the Popeye whisk over here.
Woo. My back.
You're too young to be having back problems, bro. Might be them heavy bees you got.
Right.
All right. So, flour. Don't ever fry anything in your life. You. Without seasoning your flour. Alright? Because some of the seasoning from your chicken is going to fall off as you fry it. But when you season your flour, it adds that extra layer of crispiness and crunchiness to your fried foods. But then you don't have to be that guy who seasons your chicken after it comes out the hot skillet. Alright? So, like I said, we're going to hit a little bit of cayenne, or as I love calling it, a little bit of that yang. Miko, come over there and stir that up,
bro. Okay, tell me how to stir it right, since apparently I don't do things right. Just kidding.
A little bit of black pepper.
All right.
A little bit of salt.
Yeah. Nice and mixed in.
Then I'm going to hit it with a little bit of that savory seasoning.
Okay.
Maybe a lot of that savory seasoning. Okay. Now look, I'm gonna give y'all a quick tip. Quick tip. Now I know some of y'all aren't supposed to be eating salty foods. If you want an extra layer that brings out a brightness and a flavor that has that same complement on your palate as salt, add a little bit of granulated garlic to your food. And that's going to give you that hit that you're looking for from salt, all right? When I used to do my meal plans, and my nutritionist told me I only could use so much salt, but I still wanted to add flavor, I found that adding a little bit of garlic powder, granulated garlic, did the job.
That's a great tip.
All right.
Want to switch places?
Nope, because it ain't seasoned enough.
Oh, okay.
You want to smell that. You want to taste that. Okay. Go ahead and season that up.
Oh, whoa, I can smell that now.
You can smell it too?
Yeah, I can totally smell it now.
That's what you want. All right. So, one good way to know something seasoned other than tasting is your smell. You smell it. You can smell seasoning. You can
so
smell
you don't taste your garlic?
Good food.
I mean, you're
not. I do not taste my flour. I do not do that.
I bet your grandma does.
No, my grandma don't do that. She said, baby, that's not something that we do in this family. Trust me. Y'all see that? What you?
You can't really see because of the color, because it's clear.
Thumb up for the sniff test. Thank you. So look, oh yeah, you can see the color on Facebook.
You can.
You can see it got a little tint. It got a little tint. You know what I'm saying? Are you signed up to my email list? Send me an email, burning60@chefkennethtemple@gmail.com.
Oh, you giving out
seasoning? And I'm gonna make sure that I can give you some seasoning. Yeah. Look, to those of you who've already signed up and already talked to y'all, and already talked to y'all, some of that savory seasoning is getting shipped tomorrow. All right? Send me that email. Send me an email. Uh-oh. See what shouldn't have started?
Uh-oh.
See what shouldn't have started?
Uh-oh.
Uh-huh. Pause up. Don't do that.
What the
what? Yours is on that list tomorrow.
What the what?
All right. So if y'all just joining, welcome to the Trap Kitchen Mardi Gras
Trap
Edition.
Kitchen.
My name is Chef Kenneth Temple. I am from New Orleans, Louisiana. On my days off, I love to do a little bit of cooking, and we do this thing called Trap Kitchen. Today, we are doing a fried chicken with a buttermilk biscuit with a not something I have made yet, but this might be something that I have to make for them soon. If you want this recipe and any other recipes off of Trap Kitchen, please go to my website at chefkennethtemple.com. Sign up for that email list, and I will pick a special person next week to get a bottle of my savory season before it hits the market, all right? And don't forget, if you're just getting here, share. Sharing is caring. Sharing is caring. Hit your bald head uncle on Periscope. If you're on Facebook, hit the share button. See that right there? Y'all see that little gravy dripping? See that little gravy dripping? This is what you want. So you want this to cook for about 5 to 10 minutes. Let it get all nice and concentrated and reduced. Miko.
Yeah.
I want you to get your fork from out this drawer.
Okay.
And I want you to taste that.
Okay. I can do that. Don't mind if I do.
And I want you to taste it.
Okay, so I'm getting a little red beans.
Good.
Okay.
Talk to the people.
So here, I got a little spoonful of the red beans that are cooking down with the Trinity. So that's the bell pepper, the celery, and the onion. We're going to give it a little try and make sure that it's seasoned.
Don't forget the turkey sausage.
Oh, and the turkey sausage. The turkey sausage does a great job kind of blending in with the broth already and bringing in like more flavor in there. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Do a little dance. Yeah. I'm loving that. That's going to make a great sauce.
Now, look. I know tomorrow's Ash Wednesday, and I might need to say a penance because I use red beans. This is done. This is done. All I did was season some flour, and this is done. This is why I use the quick can red bean. Not them guys who run that have a beautiful color of the sky. All right? I Christy. But this dish right here, it's done. Now all I'm going to do, Find a bay leaf, throw them out, hit it with a little bit of stock.
That's good.
And then we're going to find out, all right? Now, before we do that, I'm going to sit him back on this burner, and we're going to talk about frying some chicken, y'all.
Yeah, chicken time.
Time to fry some chicken, y'all. Now, look, the best way to fry chicken is with the bone in it, all right? Any other time, you won't get that deep, rich southern flavor from the bone marrow that releases into the chicken as it fried and just gives it this extra heightened layer of flavor. But today, since we're making a sandwich and we're not biting into any bones.
No.
I know some of y'all could clean a bone, because I'm seeing y'all in some wing joints, all right? So, Kristen wants to know what Miko did for those bees.
Hey, what happens in NOLA stays in NOLA.
Clearly she did something different than I did. All right, so that's what you always want to do when you fry chicken, right? But, take that, Miko.
Yep.
But today, since we're going to make it out of a sandwich, we're going to do something a little bit different. Now, most people, they use an egg wash, flour technique. I have found that just the buttermilk has the right thickness.
Okay. The same
thickness like you would with the milk, the egg, and then the flour.
Okay.
I find that has the right thickness. All right. So what I'm going to do is take my chicken out. Miko, come and get Periscope a shot right here so
okay.
They can see that.
Yeah.
So what I do is take my chicken. Can y'all see this color? I see this nice briny color from the seasoning. Take the chicken out. Put them in their own little corners. Kind of like you do the kids when they're cutting up. All right. And then I'm going to dredge it. Keep one hand. Oh, I just got flour all over. Keep one hand for the dry and one hand for the wet.
That's a good tip, Chef.
All right. Y'all see that? This is coming together. Now, don't be that guy or girl who only fries the chicken at this point. Don't be that guy. Don't be that girl. Look, this will make you some good chicken. I want you to be that guy and that girl who learned in the trap kitchen to dip it back in there.
Double dip.
All right. I want you to be that person, okay? I want you to be that person. Now, what this does is it causes all those beautiful, crispy blisters of the skin and of the flour that we all so love so much. Look at that color. Look at that. Be that guy, be that girl. All right? Be that guy, be that girl.
I think he deserves some hearts for that Periscope and Facebook.
Be that guy, be that girl that makes nice, crispy chicken for people who you love. Even people who you hate.
Make some crispy chicken.
Yeah, love thy enemy. You know, love your enemy as you love yourself. You know what I mean? And you love crispy fried chicken, make it for your enemy. They might become your best friend. All right? And then you just re-dip it. All right? Some of y'all called me when I was doing that fried fish and grits with that chili sauce. Same technique. Now look, after you fry chicken, you can definitely reuse this batter for about another 48 hours. It will still have all the decent flavors that you want to penetrate your chicken, all right?
You are full of tips tonight, Chef.
I mean, I gotta let you know, I can't have you coming down to New Orleans, Miko, not having a great meal. I can't have my followers, my subscribers, coming to the trap kitchen and not learning how to cook it. Because you know, in the trap, we cook it, we whip it, then we serve it. So I just need everybody eating great when they follow these recipes. All right? Now look at the blister.
Good. Oh yeah, that looks good.
Look at the blisters that's going to form on this. This is going to be a sandwich. Trap kitchen shirts are coming. Matter of fact, Miko has created a shirt with Trap Kitchen on it, and Miko in the dish underneath her t-shirt collection, and I've already placed my order for one, and I'm expecting it next week for next week's Trap Kitchen episode, where I'm going to show y'all all things rollable, all right? We're going to do some roll-ups. Facebook. Did y'all see this blister? Did y'all see these blisters? Look, that's going to equal crunchy texture. Now look, I didn't take the skin off because I love crispy skin. So when I bite into that biscuit, it's just going to be crunch, 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 crunch. All right, y'all. One for the dry, one for the wet. Now let's go ahead on over here and fry some chicken. You always want to shake it back and forth and then just drop that thing in right there. All right? Now, here's a fun fact about this chicken fryer, Miko.
Tell me more.
This is my great-grandmother's cast iron skillet that she used for fried chicken in.
So it's got a lot of flavor.
It got a lot of flavor and it got a lot of history in it. Y'all, this is going to take a few minutes to get golden brown and delicious. And while this one finished frying, give it maybe about 7 minutes, all right? And then we're going to fold it over and make sure it don't do anything wrong, all right? Give me some love if y'all love fried chicken, y'all.
Love fried chicken.
Once again, welcome to the Trap Kitchen. Woo-hoo. My name is Kenneth Temple. I am a private chef in New Orleans, Louisiana. I work with NFL, NBA, politicians, Grammy artists. I travel the world cooking great food for a lot of different people. And on my days off, I like to come into the Trap Kitchen and bring y'all some great, delicious food. If y'all want this recipe right here, jump on chefkennethtemple.com and sign up to the email list, and I will send you this recipe today. The day after, once I get the blog site all nice and typed up. But look, y'all. Can y'all see that golden brown crispiness right there in that skillet? Hold on, y'all. Can you see that? Look, we just put this in. We just put this chicken in, and it's already golden brown and delicious. Look at those. Look at that. Hey. I'm just trying to represent from the Creole cockpit for New Orleans, Louisiana, and let y'all know I know a thing or two about frying some chicken. Now, I have a confession to make about fried chicken. When I was a kid, my father only made fried chicken for me once.
What?
I've only had homemade fried chicken out of my house one time as a kid.
Your mom didn't fry chicken either?
My mama did not fry chicken either.
Wow.
I grew up on Church of Chickens and Popeyes.
Oh, so you have fried chicken, just not from them.
I didn't have homemade fried chicken. This chicken right here is a lot better than that industrial fried chicken. That's all I'm going to call it. I'm going to call it industrial fried chicken.
You shady.
That's what I'm going to call it. Industrial fried chicken. All right, y'all. We doing a great job. I'm going to pop these biscuits back in at a 200 degree oven just so they can get nice and warm. We got our red bean sauce. Red bean sauce all nice and ready to go. Let's let that chicken fry up. Bring them over here. Bring them over here. I'm going to make the red bean sauce.
All right, let's move around.
Where y'all at? Let me wash my hands.
Watch your hands, sir. Okay. You guys back over here. Sorry about the drop off, Periscope.
All right. Now. If y'all like white meat, go for it. I like my dark meat. Mm-hmm. All right. You ready about this? You ready for the red bean sauce, Nico?
I'm ready. I've been ready. Come on now.
Go ahead.
Some of that action. I love those little hand blenders. You're welcome.
Add a little bit more stock. Give it that saucy edge. These little stick blenders work magic, y'all. Hey! That's a red bean sauce, y'all. I love to have a little bit of body, so when you bite into it, you know you're eating red beans. Just a little bit of body. Look, ain't nothing wrong with having a good body, y'all. And this right here, Miko, where your fork at? You need a spoon.
I need a spoon, you know, for this.
Yeah, take that.
Okay.
Take that.
This really, it actually reminds me of eating like red beans and rice.
Mm-hmm.
It has all the flavors of red beans and rice. And also because I grew up in San Diego, so I used to eat refried beans, so it kind of has that thickness, that smooth, creamy thickness of like a refried bean, but it has just the more like Cajun flavor. I really, really like that. How are you going to pull that all together with the sandwich.
That's going right over the top.
It goes right over the top.
That's going right over the
That's
top.
That's delicious. Yeah.
That's going right over the top.
You can taste like all of the fresh vegetables that you put in there. Mm-hmm. It's like you didn't cook them to oblivion. They still maintained a lot of their original flavors. Yeah, yeah. Super good, guys. Sorry you can't taste it. Sorry, not sorry, because that means more for me. All right, okay. And I hear the sizzle from that chicken. Yum. Mm.
So that's the red bean sauce, people.
That's the red bean sauce.
That's the red bean sauce, all right? Nice, creamy, quick, underneath 10 minutes to cook, all right? Look, in the trap kitchen, you don't have all day to be in the trap. You got to get in and get out, or else it gets too hot. We got some fried chicken.
That chicken is beautiful.
Chicken is so good, Facebook don't want the people to see it.
Facebook is acting up. Ooh, that looks good. Wow, that is so pretty. It looks super crunchy, too. I love a crunchy chicken. Wow.
We left the skin on. But clearly we could have took it off. Because it is bad.
Thanks for sharing, called Top Praise One. Whoa.
Come on, y'all.
Whoa.
Come on, y'all. Mardi Gras 2017 in a trap, y'all. Mardi Gras 2017 in a trap. Don't be that friend who only batters your chicken once. Be that friend who batters.
Yeah, skin on.
Be that friend who batters your chicken twice. And like I said, when you're frying chicken, don't just throw it in there. Two reasons why you just don't throw it in there. One is so you don't splatter yourself with hot grease. But two, you want to just make sure it's nice and ready and prime and lay it on down in there. Like I said, y'all want to make food like Keith Sweat. Y'all don't want to make food like Trey Songz, all right? You want food that's going to make love when it gets hit the skillet. You want to make food like Johnny Gill sung about when he said, my, my, my. You know what I'm talking about? You don't want that food that where you buy drinks in the club for the girl unless that's your girl. You want to make sure that whoever you make this dish for, you know, and they know that you made it with love. You know what I'm talking about?
I feel the love.
That's good. All right, y'all. So what we going to do, we're going to turn this beautiful neutral drink. I'm going to clean up some things, and we're going to get this trap kitchen nice and cleaned up. We're going to turn up some nice trap music, and we're going to get ready to have some fun and bring this thing together with Miko's Mardi Gras tree lair drink.
Daiquiri.
Give me some love on Facebook if y'all love it. Give me some love on Periscope. You know one thing I know about my followers? Y'all pay attention. Y'all really do be paying attention. So, I'm going to do some cleaning up so we can bring this dish together.
Okay, I'm going to reset everything up. You
want to
move this?
I'm about to break all this down. So, look, since Miko's right here, y'all, Miko, tell the people where they can find you, what's your website, what you're up to.
Plug time. I'm Miko from Miko and the Dish. That's my food blog. So MikoandTheDish.com is where you can find me. M-E-I-K-O and TheDish.com. I'm a food blogger based out of Dallas, but also a co-host with Kenneth on the Black Food Network. And I am here visiting, hanging out for the trap kitchen. I'm so excited to be here. Thank you for having me.
Thank you for having me.
We ain't that crazy. Well, actually, we are. Yeah. But we're having a ball right now. So, can I use this table or not? I'm going to make a drink for you guys. You cannot have none of this Southern goodness without a nice cocktail, daiquiri, something. So
this is what Miko didn't tell y'all, all right? Periscope, somebody asked about Trap Kitchen t-shirts. I bought one off of her website that says Trap Kitchen. Miko, stop playing with the people. They're all foodies. They're all tuned in. Let them know they could buy some foodie t-shirts.
You are a great promoter for me. So I'm also the creator of the foodie apparel line, Dish Rags, and I sell my Dish Rags apparel on my website. So you'll see, if you are a foodie, you'll see a range of different like foodie shirts that kind of represent our love for food in so many different ways. You could be a wino, a foodie, a person who loves Southern food, whatever your heart's desire, you'll find it on the site. So why don't you guys can go over there, check it out, MikoandTheDish.com, while we're doing this little praise break. Check out this site, get you some nice foodie apparel, and I'm going to gift Kenneth a nice Trap Kitchen shirt since
On the house, because I'm expecting this food to be good.
So since I already bought it, that means she's giving me a refund, y'all. That's what that means.
Or if you already bought it, then I might as well just keep my funds, my coins, my... Yeah.
There you go. See y'all? They say they're going to hook you up.
Okay. Looks like we are set up now. So we about to get started on this little bevy here. Let's get you guys set up over here on Periscope. So as Kenneth mentioned, I am going to be making a drink. I am calling it my Mardi Gras Daiquiri. Oh, I gotta get my buns out the way.
Yes, I'm trying to get some buns out there.
Look at, oh man, every time he brings out those muffins. Maybe I was looking at my muffin top and thinking muffin, my bad. Okay, I'm gonna take this off for the hell of it because I need to focus now.
Focus, man.
And we're gonna get to this real, real quick. This is not gonna take any time. So let me get out my ingredients.
Periscope, all right. I'm coming to play cameraman in 2 seconds.
When do I get a cameraman? Okay, so we're going to make our Mardi Gras daiquiri, which is going to be 3 different flavored layers of frozen slushy goodness with a hint of this yummy Tito's vodka. So what we're going to start off with is one of the frozen like juice drinks that you'll find in the frozen section of the grocery store. Super simple. I got my blender over here. Can you guys see the blender? Bring you guys down some so you can see what's happening over here. Here, let's go. Thank you, Kenneth. You can be my cameraman now. Done. Okay. All right, so here's our blender. So all we're going to do is this one live. We're going to take this, open it up, pour it in. Oh, that's got that nice, rich purple color. Huh?
Look like Kool-Aid.
Could you please stop hating on Kool-Aid? I mean, Kool-Aid has had enough of your beating, okay? There's nothing wrong with Kool-Aid.
Nothing at all. I grew up on Kool-Aid.
Okay, then. Stop the hate. So we've got that nice purple flavor. I'm going to add in some Tito's. I'm going to add in about 5 tablespoons of it. Boom. And then I like to add in some ice because I want it to be like a slushy. So I added about 2 to 2.5, I would say, cups of ice, depending on how watered down your juice mix is. This one we got from the grocery store, and it seems to be a little bit watery, so some of this ice is gonna thicken it up. And we're gonna have to play around with this blender because he's got a trap kitchen blender.
Hey.
He's got a trap kitchen blender. And if you're using any of the flavors that don't have like their own rich color, you can also use like a pack of Kool-Aid to help bring out the color. So if you're not doing a Mardi Gras color daiquiri, why don't you just, you know, if you're trying to like do a green and the green isn't quite as green as you'd like it to, you can get a green Kool-Aid added to it and it'll bring out the color of it. So I'm gonna add a little bit more of this just to make sure my color comes out deep purple. Boom. So remember what went in here is my juice, my little juice can, some Tito's, some ice, and some Kool-Aid. And now we're going to
it needs more liquor.
It needs more liquor.
It needs more liquor.
You alky. Listen.
Fat Tuesday. Mardi Gras. More liquor.
I am not about to deal with you after this show goes off.
Hey.
And you drunk as hell.
Give me some hearts. Give me some love on Facebook Live and Periscope if y'all think she needs more liquor. Yes, look, they want more liquor. did that live. I'm the friend.
Margarita, and I added, yeah, this is the flavor that I got from the store. So I added like a Bacardi margarita flavor, and I added a green lemon lime Kool-Aid to it to bring out that really, really deep green. And this is a mango. Have that one here? I don't think so. And this is like a mango one. Oh, here we go. This is actually peach. I actually use peach, and then I use...
We in the South, peach work.
I use the yellow Kool-Aid to go with that. So it was like a lemon Kool-Aid to go with that to bring out some of that color as well. All right, so this is another thing. Just because it's Mardi Gras, you just can't like just do the daiquiri and be done. You gotta do a little extra. So I got my friend right here. Can you grab me that bowl? These Pop Rocks. And so that as it goes down, it pops in your mouth.
You might ask me what I'm trying to do.
Listen, snap, crackle, pop, baby. Yes, this is my, now this is about to be bomb. If they had yellow, I'd get them yellow, but there's no yellow, so we're just going to do a mix of purple and green Pop Rocks.
When the Sam cooks.
Oh, but you know, these purple, oh, shady, these purple ones don't even come out purple. What?
It's purple flavor.
Purple flavor, but not purple. Oh man, what a disappointment. Here, yeah, add some more. Are those purple?
These pink.
Yeah, these are pink too. Well, how shady is that? Well.
It's purple flavor.
Well, I'm disappointed. Okay, so I have my pink and green Pop Rocks in here, and I basically coated each of our cups with a little bit of honey around the rim. Clearly it's kind of slipped down, but super simple, and this is what's gonna make the Pop Rocks adhere to the side of the cup. So it'll look like this. If they were purple, then that would be so festive, but they're tricky. All right. Boom, boom, boom. Oh, 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 look at that. Love it, okay. So let's get these Mardi Gras colors and flavors up in here. I'm gonna start off with the green. Get that in there. Can you guys see what's going on over there? Okay, great. Woo, woo, woo. Get this green in there. Yes. Thank you, cameraman.
I didn't want the chicken to burn.
All right, let's. I'm telling you.
Nico, you holding out on how much liquor you pouring in?
Yes, I am. And then we're going to top it off with our beautiful purple layer. Mm. Yes, that looks so good.
Yeah, I'm glad I put as much liquor as I did.
Oh, it's popping, it's popping, they're popping.
You're trying to mess my mouth up, huh?
Basically.
I got to finish talking on
and voila.
Sit that right here for Facebook Live.
You gotta get them in the view. And this is my Mardi Gras daiquiri. Super simple. And when you drink it, it'll be like, can I drink some of mine?
I don't know what you're gonna do with yours.
That's good, huh? That's good, huh?
See the way my mouth works? Because I'm drinking. Mm-hmm. I like the combination. I like the fact that soon as you taste it, you get the grape, but then you know the next layer you're going to get the peach, then the next layer you're going to finish with the margarita.
Exactly.
So you literally have like three different drinks
in one.
In one.
Yeah.
And they're all going to come with a nice surprise.
Dope.
Okay.
Super easy.
Okay.
Super easy, guys. And you can mix any flavors that you want. Of course, this is Mardi Gras edition, but if you're doing 4th of July, you can do red, white, and blue. Right? So.
All right.
All right, I'm going to clear out.
So that's Miko.
And you can get this recipe at MikoInTheDish.com.
So that's Miko with her Pop Rocks. Like, I don't have to finish talking again. So. Give us some love, y'all. Give us some love, Facebook Live. Periscope, y'all doing a great job. That drink tastes bomb. Only thing I would say is Miko better stop being miserable when she's pouring my liquor. That's all. Since we're talking about players.
Whoa.
We're talking about players. We're talking about players. All right. All right. Y'all see that Facebook?
That looks good.
You see that?
That's chicken.
All right.
Oh, my goodness.
All right.
Oh, my goodness.
This is what we're going to do. Slide right here so Facebook can see that. Let me slide so Facebook can see that. Moment of truth, y'all.
Oh, my God. You hear that crunch?
See that?
Whoa.
You see in the camera. You see that?
Wow.
You see that? Be the friend. Miko. I know you're playing camera woman.
Yes. Don't try to feed me, Kenneth. What kind of party do you think this is, okay?
Let's say bon ton roulette. Crunch, texture. Look at this. This is just a little crispy bit. But I promise y'all, nice deep flavor all the way throughout the bite. But this thing would have a higher concentration of flavor if I let it marinate. All right. Let's bring this thing together. Let's bring this thing together. Hold on.
Be the friend that shares this live broadcast before we finish putting this together, okay? Oh, okay. Bringing out some marbles.
Hey, look. Look, I ain't gonna tell y'all how I got this marble, but just know it didn't fall off the back of a truck. Just know it didn't fall off the back of a truck. So, while Miko was hooking up her drink, I did a little brown butter. Now, here's how you make brown butter. There's two ways. There's a real chef technique, and then there's the trap kitchen technique. The chef technique is you will carefully let the butter begin to brown and create a nice nutty flavor, and then you will pour it over anything you're serving. The trap kitchen way, look, I honestly forgot I had the butter on in the back, and it got brown on me. All right, but brown butter brings out a very, very nutty flavor to anything that you put it on. So I just poured it over the biscuit. All right.
Sorry, guys, y'all missed that.
So.
Wow. Red bean sauce. I mean, basically, if I was eating red beans and rice and chicken, I would scoop all it up in one bite and eat it just like this. Okay, hot sauce. Yes, Crystal.
I'm loving this. I'm gonna add it to, hey, I'm gonna add it to the blog. So look for it tomorrow. The recipe's going up tomorrow.
Y'all see this?
Yes.
Do y'all see this? Do you see that? Do y'all see that?
Look. It's all turned purple now.
Look, buttermilk biscuits. We add a little bit black pepper, so a little bit more savoriness to it. I got some green in here somewhere. Not that type of green trap. Not that type of trap. Hold on.
A little green. Okay. You're an artist, Kenneth.
I dabble. So look, what y'all think about this fried chicken buttermilk biscuit sandwich with a red bean sauce?
Yeah, the purple on the bottom sounds like a good idea.
Give me some ones. Give me some hearts. Give me some thumbs up if y'all think this is something y'all want to make. Talk to me, y'all. This is something, if you're on your cell phone.
I see a lot of ones.
This is something you should take on your cell phone and take a screenshot of this, right? And then tell somebody, look what I cooked, girl. Look what I cooked, bruh. You know what I'm saying? Look, go lie to them and tell them you made it yourself. I don't care. Because y'all going to come back to the trap next Tuesday at 7:30. I appreciate y'all joining this Mardi Gras edition. This right here. It's a work of art, y'all.
Look, y'all.
What's up, Kenny? Look, y'all. Hold on, y'all. I want to talk to y'all, but I want y'all to just look at that while I talk to y'all. What y'all think about this, man? Look, don't look at me. Look at the dish. Periscope, what y'all think? Hearts, love. What y'all think, y'all? Y'all want to see how it tastes, huh? Facebook Live, I appreciate y'all. I truly do appreciate y'all. Look, y'all. We got a few more weeks to go in this Trap Kitchen thing. If y'all are enjoying it, please share it. If y'all are enjoying it, please let me know. I'm really just trying to bring y'all some beautiful content, some fun things that y'all all can enjoy, because I'm about to turn up my content level and I'm about to start coming for people's throats. All right? Black Food Network supposed to be getting back underneath wraps in a couple of months. We're going to tighten up and bring some more creations. Cooking course coming up. I'm having a problem with my people with the membership site. Lord have mercy. We're going to get that thing under wraps, but what I might do is something real special. So stay on top of that. If you signed up for my email list tonight, I thank you. If you shared this tonight, I thank you. If you came back consistently, I thank you. If y'all enjoyed Miko in the dish being here for Mardi Gras with her cocktail, that's a daiquiri.
How did I do?
I thank you. And if y'all go look at Darius' stuff on Periscope right now, me and y'all going to fight. Tell Darius he knows what's going on right now. What up, D? All right, y'all. I appreciate that. Once again, if you signed up to my email list, this recipe is coming straight to you. Now, for the moment of truth, I'm going to give my guest of honor the privilege of cutting herself a piece and then letting y'all know what it tastes like.
Yes.
All right, Nico.
I'm not trying to put that big old thing in my mouth. Oh my gosh.
I'm gonna let y'all look at that piece right there. What piece you want, right here?
Yeah, right there, that corner. That corner looks like it has my name on it. Okay, so I'm looking at it right away and you can kind of like see this is super, like, my finger makes an indentation into this because it's so soft. It's like one of those mattresses that you want to sleep on that reserves your body molding. So I'm excited already. Mmm. That crunch. Mmm. I just feel like the red bean sauce just kind of brings it all together. That's so good. I'm sorry y'all can't have this. But you can make it yourself. Mmm. This chicken is so crunchy. Mmm.
Look. She's trying to describe what it tastes like.
I like that the sausage is also the little sausage bits on the top. Mm-hmm. That has a whole totally different texture to it.
Come on with it. Mm. Look, y'all. I ain't playing with these people. Thank you, Jasmine. Thank you. If you're on Periscope, please, chefkennethtemple.com so the people can know where to find me. Look, y'all. If y'all work for a company, if y'all are part of some fraternities, y'all coming to New Orleans, and y'all won't have me come there, me and my team will be glad to work with you so we can bring y'all some of this dopeness. If you're close to the surrounding areas of New Orleans, Louisiana, get ready. Pop-ups are coming in New Orleans. Pop-ups are coming in New Orleans. So when you see all this food, you'll be able to taste all this food. And it'll do one thing. It tastes better than it looks. It tastes better than it looks.
It looks pretty damn good too.
It tastes better than it looks. We've all had the situation when we hollered at a pretty young thing, man or woman, and then it had a stank attitude and it killed the complete mold. This right here is God's heaven sent to earth to make sure that you are loved for the rest of your life. What are y'all drinking? Miko, the people on North Periscope, what are we drinking again?
We're drinking a Mardi Gras daiquiri, and it has all the layers of Mardi Gras, so the purple, the yellow, the green in it. It's a little bit of like those frozen juices mixed with Tito's vodka and a little Kool-Aid. And ice. And Pop Rocks.
Facebook, you see that? You see that crunch? This is a crunch right here. Y'all see that Periscope?
Oh my gosh.
Hey.
I'm dying with this chicken
right now. Hey. Miko came in here, never heard of a red bean sauce before. I think Miko might be jacking my dish. Now look, if y'all in any other areas of the world, follow this recipe. You can use this for black beans. You can use this for white beans. Matter of fact, use any kind of bean you want and make this dish right here. I'm gonna go take a picture after I finish eating. And I'm gonna see y'all soon. If y'all not following me on Instagram, stop playing yourself. I thank y'all for being here. Miko, thank you for being here.
My pleasure.
Forget that hat. I will talk to y'all soon. I will talk to y'all later. Thank y'all for joining me in the Trap Kitchen. I have dishes to go wash now.
Yeah, I'm the guest, so I don't wash dishes.
Milwaukee going to a Mardi Gras event. Where at in Milwaukee, Periscope? I thank y'all for sharing it. I thank y'all for y'all time. I will see y'all next Tuesday in the Trap, where I'm going to teach y'all somewhere between, I'm trying to decide between a crab and corn egg roll or my red velvet crepes.
Have them both.
I'm trying to see. You need a little savory, you need a little sweet. So, I thank y'all very much. Hey, Miss Tara, I thank y'all very much. I hope y'all enjoyed everything on the Trap Kitchen Live. Once again, we made some fried chicken with a buttermilk biscuit with a red bean sauce. Miko made a beautiful New Orleans Mardi Gras daiquiri. Y'all already voting on Periscope, huh? They ain't playing. Say Facebook Live. Periscope already asking for egg rolls, y'all. So, I love y'all. I appreciate y'all's time. I do not take y'all for granted. I will see y'all next week in the Trap.
In the Trap.